All right, it's August 8th, so we're getting ready to start thinking about back to school. Certainly the stores have with their advertising and their floor space. But I wanted to show you a few things that were new to start the school year this year coming up. Three of them in Google, one of them in Screencastify. I'll start with the low-hanging fruit in Screencastify. You may have always noticed that down here in the corner, gotta go this way, is my little webcam when I'm using Screencastify. It used to be fixed. You'd pick which corner you wanted it in. Now you can actually freely move the webcam around your screen. You can also change the size of it. And you can even, using keyboard shortcuts, toggle it on and off whenever you want. So if it seems to be blocking a particular piece of the screen and you want to just toggle it off, that is always an option now for you. So I'm going to put it back down here in the bottom right-hand corner. That's new to Screencastify. So if you're a Screencastify user like I am, it's a nice little feature that lets you control the built-in webcam. All right. So Google has a bunch of new things for classroom teachers this year and for anybody who uses Google. The two things for classroom teachers we'll start off with. First, in Google Forms, under the settings, so to get to this screen, I simply click on the little settings icon up here in the corner, and I go to quizzes. And now when I make a Google Form a quiz, I have the option to turn on locked mode. And basically what this means is that students won't be able to switch to other tabs or open up any other applications on their Chromebook when they're taking a Google Forms quiz, okay? The catch is it has to be on a school-issued Chromebook for this to work. It won't work that way on a phone. It won't work that way on a PC. It's on a Shen School's Chromebook. You can have this lock mode feature turn on when a student is taking a quiz in Forms. They can't go to other tabs. They can't open other applications. It's a brand new tool from Google. It might be a little buggy to start out with, but please send me some feedback once you start using it and let me know how it's working out. It's similar to the eDoctrina locked mode. Okay, so that's in Google Forms. It's a option in the settings under quizzes once you make a form a quiz to lock it so that people can't leave it. All right, so I'll close that one up. Google Classroom's got a new feature too. And this new feature hopefully will actually extend in the future for us at Shen, but for now it is what it is. So when you have your Google Classroom set up, you'll now notice a fourth tab as a teacher called Grades. What this does is instead of just having individual assignments with individual grades, is it gives you an overall view of all the assignments you've issued and all the grades you've given. Now, these people over here on the left-hand side are just people who voluntarily took a class at some point, and the grades on the assignments are not reflective of their ability. So don't be calling Rose and saying, I see you only got an 80 on that assignment in Google Classroom. All right? So it gives you a class average. It shows you the assignments. One of the keys in this new tool is that when you give a grade on an assignment, it will not reflect in the overall grade until that assignment has been returned to the student or to all the students. So from here, I can return that just to her, and then it should affect the average for that person. Okay. You can also come up here to the assignment at the top and return all of the graded assignments to all of the students. Okay. If an assignment is turned in, you can actually view the submission by clicking on the three dots, and instead of saying return, go to view submission, and it will pull it up for you. So you now have one universal grade book that will show all of your students, all the assignments you've given in Google Classroom, and the class and the grades for those assignments. The one caveat for you at this point is, because I know what the next question is going to be, is will this export to SIS? And the answer is, at the current time, no. Google is working on a beta with a couple of different school districts on trying to get that functionality to work. As of this point, because it's a beta, Shen is not involved in that process. But somewhere down the line, this may actually transfer right over to SIS, similar to what's going to be happening with eDoctrina. All right, so that's the new gradebook in Google Classroom. Okay, so you've got the new gradebook. Oops, I can never figure out where the camera is. The new gradebook, locked forms, and those are the two teacher tools for Google's school launch. There is a general tool that's been launched now called the priority section of your Google Drive. It's available to anybody. You can get it at home too. It doesn't have to be a school-based account. The priority section now takes that same quick access toolbar and puts it at the top where Google tries to figure out things you've used recently or things you usually at this time of the year, and it puts them here for you to quickly work on. Not really a super useful tool in my case. The AI hasn't gotten to the point where it's always guessing even close to what I want. I work on way too many documents apparently for these few that they put up here in the scroll bar to actually have meaning. But hopefully that'll improve as time goes on. It's not really that part of the priority page I wanted to show you. It's this workspace page part, which is really cool. So I put one together real quick by just clicking create workspace and giving it a name, and then it allows you to pick files. And I took two different documents that have to do with the student help desk, the shed at the high school, and I put them into one workspace. You can have up to 50 documents in a workspace. They can come from any of your resources. They can come from a shared drive, shared with me, six different folders in your drive, and then they're all collected into one place. So when you begin a project, it might be nice to capture all these resources that are in different places without moving them all into one space. And that's what a workspace does. Workspaces aren't shared currently at the current time. They're not shared. Oh, I'm sorry. It's a 25 file limit on that shared space. You can click here to add files to it, or as you're browsing your drive, if you come across a file that belongs in a workspace, you right click on it and can say add to workspace, where you will then see, of course, right behind my picture, where you will then see any of your existing workspaces, or you can create a new one. So it's a kind of a neat idea to be able to collect resources from all over your Google Drive into one workspace. And you can remove that workspace at any time. So those are the three new tools in Google and the one new tool in Screencastify.